So in this session, I am going to explain conservation of energy and conservation of linear momentum and conservation of angular momentum. So first one, conservation of energy. Conservation of energy. This one also called as conservation of mechanical energy. Conservation of mechanical energy. So here consider, suppose conservative forces operate on a system, and W be the work done. Then we can write U suffix F minus U suffix I equal to W, and W equal to K suffix F minus K suffix I. Here K suffix F and K suffix I are initial kinetic energy and final kinetic energy. This is the final potential energy and this is the initial potential energy. Here K suffix F and K suffix I are the final and initial kinetic energies. Kinetic energies of the system of particles and hence we can write U suffix F minus U suffix I equal to minus W equal to minus of K suffix F minus K suffix I. From this we can write U suffix I plus K suffix I equal to U suffix F plus K suffix F. This approves the conservation of mechanical energy. So here the total energy of a system of particles remains constant. The energy neither be created nor be destroyed, and it can be transferred from one form to another form. From this we can say that the total energy of a system of particles remains constant. Here the conservative forces operate on this system and W be the work done. We can write this is the final potential energy and this is the initial energy. So we can write minus W equal to U suffix F minus U suffix I, and work done W equal to K suffix F minus K suffix I, where K suffix F and K suffix I are the final and initial kinetic energies. From that, u suffix f minus u suffix I equal to minus w. That means minus of k suffix f minus k suffix I. From this, u suffix I plus k suffix I equal to u suffix f plus k suffix f. So this equation u suffix I plus k suffix I equal to u suffix f plus k suffix f. So this approves the conservation of mechanical energy as follows. The total energy of a system of particles system of particles remains constant The energy is neither be created nor be destroyed. And it can be transformed from one form to another form. For example, freely falling body and projected body. So this is about conservation of energy. So u suffix I plus k suffix I equal to u suffix f plus k suffix s. From this, this approves the conservation of mechanical energy. The total energy of a system of particles remains constant. The energy is neither be created nor be destroyed. And it can be transformed from the one form to another form. Example, freely falling body and projected body. Second one, conservation of linear momentum. Conservation of linear momentum. According to the law of conservation of linear momentum, conservation of linear momentum conservation of linear momentum the total linear momentum of the particles the total linear momentum of the particles the linear momentum of the particles of a system is equal to the product of total mass of a system and velocity of its center of mass. So in conservation of linear momentum, according to the law of conservation of linear momentum, the total linear momentum of the particles of a system is equal to the product of total mass of a system and velocity of its center of mass. So according to the law of conservation of linear momentum, when no external force acts on an isolated system of particles, then the linear momentum of the system remains constant. That means according to Newton's second law, F equal to dP by dt. So for system of particles, we can write summation I equal to 1 to n, F equal to summation I equal to 1 to n, dP by dt. When no external force acts on the system, we can write summation I equal to 1 to n, P suffix I equal to constant. So from this, according to the law of conservation of linear momentum, the total linear momentum of the particles of a system is this value equal to the product of total mass of a system and velocity. That means m into v. Total momentum, linear momentum represented with letter p. This value equal to mass into velocity. Mass into velocity. Next, according to the law of conservation of linear momentum, here when no external force acts on a system means there is no force, F value equal to zero. Already we know that from Newton's second law, F equal to dP by dt. F equal to dP by dt. Here no external force means F value equal to zero. According to the law of conservation of linear momentum, according to the law of conservation of linear momentum, no external force, no external force acts on a system. That means F value equal to 0.